Hello, Curious Minds. I'm Miles Maxcer, and welcome back to the Ant Network. And welcome to my apartment. These are some weird times that we're living in now, and I do hope that you've been able to get outside a little bit and maybe even find some queen ants. Today I'm going to cover a topic that I get asked about all the time. Folks message me and say, "Hey Miles, I found this queen ant. What do I do next?" It is an awesome accomplishment to find a queen ant, and it's critically important that you care for her properly. In this video, I'm going to show you how I bring queen ants into my collection and get them set up, and I'm also going to show you how to move a small ant colony into a formicarium. The methods that I'm going to demonstrate next are best suited for fully claustral queen ants. These are queens that can actually raise their first workers without having to go and forage for food. Instead, they rely on energy reserves, like fats that they have inside their body. They also metabolize their wing muscles, which they no longer need after they've shed their wings following their mating flight. If you've collected a semi-claustral queen, make sure to feed her throughout the founding process. And if you've collected a socially parasitic queen, well, that's a little bit more complicated, and we'll have to cover them another time. Here is a Campanotus queen that I just collected. When I bring new ants to the collection, I always do a visual inspection to see if they have any visible parasites or injuries. If they look good, I give them a small drop of sugar or honey water. This is not necessary, but it probably helps them recoup some of their lost energy. You can give them a small droplet, no larger than their head, in their collection vial. Next, I move them into a founding formicarium or a test tube. I'm going to move this queen into one of our petri dish formicaria. To prepare the habitat, I will moisturize it. Next, I will gently coax the queen inside. Don't dump her if you can avoid it, as the ant will likely panic in that case. There we go. She is all ready to begin laying eggs, and she'll have a fledgling colony in no time. Here's another scenario. I found this formica queen yesterday, and she has already begun to lay eggs. Because she has brood, it's too risky to give her liquid food at this stage. I'm going to move her into a test tube and gently tap her eggs in. Once she's settled, I'll add the end of a Q-tip soaked in honey water on a foil tray. This keeps the environment mostly free of contamination, which can cause problems, especially in test tube setups. Remove the food a few hours later. You can learn how to set up a test tube for your ants by watching our linked tutorial. Finally, I collected a small myrmica colony under a rock. They are in this aspirator vial and desperately need a new home. Luckily, I have a bifurcated mini hearth formicarium available, and it will be perfect for this species. I have applied Fluon along the top rim and added distilled water to the water tower. New users of the mini hearth may not recognize that the water tower is intended to be filled to approximately 3/4 of its capacity. This allows the water to slowly evaporate and raise the humidity without soaking the stone material. Because Myrmica are moisture-loving ants, I also added some water through a port, and I've attached a nest mate to the formicarium. Now, I'll gently put the vial in the outworld and remove the cap. If the ants do not move out quickly, you may cover the nest environment to make them more at home. You can use light to encourage them to move, but make sure you don't create a greenhouse effect and cook them. In this tutorial, I demonstrated some steps that you can take to properly set up your queen ants for success in captivity. If you enjoyed this video, drop us a like and subscribe, and also let us know in the comments if you have any questions. If you're interested in ant keeping, be sure to check out our other tutorials. And if you want to go on an ant adventure with me, watch some of our Ant Explorer episodes. Thanks for watching.